Hi, my name is Angela Clark and I'm with Thread-Legal Quilting. Today I'm going to show you what the marking tool is in Quilt Path and Quilter's Creative Touch. And I'm going to do that by working on a Dream Big leaf panel that I've been I'm going to be shooting for a video that's part of my advanced video on demand series on Vimeo. So we're going to start out by talking about what the marking tool is and why you may want to use it. So you can see that I'm in Select and Sew. My pattern is roughly 14 inches square. I want to do this as a 1-point center. I only want to mark the very center of my quilt, which very nicely has lines in it in this pattern. You can see them right here. Okay, and so I want to use that as my marking point. But what I want to do is I want to see where these leaves are on the surface of my quilt on my screen so I can make sure that this is falling exactly where it needs to. So I've actually marked the center of the quilt already, but what I'm going to do now is go into plugins at the top right, and I'm going to go to the marking tool, and I was playing earlier, but I'm going to go ahead and erase that. What I want to do is have a graphical representation on my screen where my leaves are on my quilt tab. So the way that I'm going to do that is start on, I'm going to start anywhere on my quilt. I'm just going to start in this V of the design, and I'm going to add a point. Okay, so if I was doing this using my screen, I would be moving my design a little bit, adding another point, right, and continuing that up and down. There are some ways that you can like hang your hand off and try to hit it, or rest your hand down here and try to hit it. But I have found a much easier way to do this. So I'm going to actually remove the last point that I just put in. And I'm going to turn my light on my long arm, because I think you might be able to see a little bit better that way. And I have got a USB finger mouse on my machine. Once I hit add button once, all I have to do is click the left button, and I can continue to add marks. You want to make sure you have tapped add plus once. Once you do that, you can actually hit the button on your finger mouse and follow your shape around the screen. And you can hear me hitting it pretty fast as I'm going. Oops. That little boop glitch should be just fine. It does take a couple minutes to do, because you want to be pretty accurate on it. With the marking tool, you can add multiple marks. One mark would be one closed shape. Anytime you don't want a line showing on your screen between two marks, you would want to add an additional one, right? So if you're doing something like I had concentric flowers, or I could mark more than one of these leaves at a time, I would add a separate mark for every leaf I was gonna put on here, or every group of leaves, like this is a group of leaves, right? And then add points on those marks to get the shape to show on my screen. And every once in a while, I pause and I look up at my screen to make sure that what I'm actually putting in it is correct. So you can tell that I did a 1-point set on this already, and that it is centered in my design. So I'm going to show you that by, I'm just going to move it somewhere and hit 1 point so you can see it move out of the design, and you just see the shape of the marking tool. When I come back in and I mark on my center point, you can see that it's now matching my design. And I can play with I can play with it a little bit. I want to make sure that it's actually quilting in the orange part of my design. So I'm okay that it's floating a little bit. I would rather float inside of a design as opposed to quilting outside of it. But let me show you how to do a second mark real quick so you know how to do that too. We're going to go back to plugins and I'm going to do marking tool. And this time I'm going to go on the left side and I'm going to do add mark. And I'm just going to name it two. I need to give it a name. Okay, it always starts out with default being one. So you're adding points to whichever one is highlighted. In this case, number two is highlighted. And let's go ahead and do one of the leaves over here real quick so you can see what I'm saying. I would start by pushing add mark so that I know one's added. And then I would just start adding points again. And you can see, I mean, it's all how slow you do it. This leaf has lots of detail in it. I don't know if I'm gonna need that detail or not. I think I'm just gonna zoom down this other side. And keep marking my quilt. So now you see the outline of the second leaf on there. And I would just continue to add leaves as I needed to to be able to do anything in my quiltable space in one go. So I want to quilt everything I can that's between my two rollers right now, and then I will roll and do the next item. So that's really all that marking tool is. All that it does is put points on your screen so that you can have a reference to what's on your quilt top up on your tablet as well. It is super easy to use. It really does increase the speed of your custom quilting, and it lets you not have to trace as much because you can immediately see if your project is in the space that you want it to be. And if not, you can move it around until it is. I still do trace occasionally. I'm not gonna say I don't trace at all, but I don't trace near as much as I used to before Marking Tool came out. Once again, I'm Angela Clark and I'm with Threadwaggle Quilting. If you like my video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like this video. I also teach a lot of classes on Quilt Path, which is also Quilter's Creative Touch, on Vimeo, and they are also on my website, which is threadwaggle.com. I'm going to put links in the description below for you. I'm also going to link to this wonderful finger mouse I found. There's also something called a pen mouse you can use. Both of them, you just strap them to your long arm and you can click just that easily and add points. You can also use them with fabric compensation and with multi-point.